Hey folks, welcome to the Physics Labs. This week we're going to be taking a look at conservation of momentum. Now in the past, we've looked at problems by analyzing the kinematics, talking about the forces themselves. Later on this semester, we'll take a look at some conservation of energy stuff, but this week, it's all about momentum, mass times velocity, and trying to understand exactly how that all works. Now, the first station is probably the coolest one that we've got for you folks, and it might not be a typical collision like you would think of, but it's the ballistocardiogram. When your heart beats, it pushes blood generally straight up, which then does a really quick U-turn through the aorta. Now, if you've accelerated that blood downwards, you've pushed the blood down, which means that blood has pushed you up slightly, and that's the interaction, the collision that we're trying to analyze here. What we're going to have you do is sit down cross-legged on the force plate here and try to hold as still as possible and record what happens to your apparent weight as you're sitting down on the force plate. What you're going to see is every single time your heart beats, your apparent weight is going to decrease just slightly because, again, if you push that blood down, the blood pushes you up and makes it appear like you weigh a little bit less. If you take a look at the force graph, you can estimate roughly what is the area that you lost during that collision there. And using that, you can figure out what was the change in your own momentum, which, thanks to conservation, is the same change of momentum of the blood. And if you know that change of momentum, we can calculate the mass of blood that your heart beats every single time it contracts, and that's pretty darn cool. Now, we'll be using these force plates for a couple other activities too. One is called hitting the wall, and we're going to take a look at some boxing gloves and grappling gloves and trying to figure out exactly what happens when you punch a surface. Now, the grappling gloves themselves have a fairly thin layer of foam cushioning. The boxing gloves are a much thicker layer. And we want to understand exactly how do these different layers of cushion affect the punch that you apply. Now, we can analyze this a little bit more carefully if we change some settings on the LabQuest unit. So we go ahead, wake this thing up. What you want to do is click over here on the rate. Make sure that we change this rate to 1,000 samples per second, because that collision happens really, really quick, and we want to understand exactly what's happening inside that collision. All right. Once you've done that, then you're good to go. Start collecting data. Smack this a few times. Again, be really careful. Make sure that you don't hurt yourself, and try to keep the force less than about 3,000 newtons or so we don't hurt the force plate either. But then we can understand exactly what is cushioning doing for us, which is pretty darn neat. Now, there's other things that we can take a look at collision-wise. One is going to be with a soccer ball here, and there's two stations we can do with a soccer ball. The first one is going to be looking at a header. And what we want to do is ideally have the soccer ball come straight in, smack you in the face, so we get this nice horizontal collision going on. Now, of course, that's not terribly painless. So instead, if you're going to have it, go ahead and hit your forehead. Make sure that the ball is coming in horizontally, all right? If you toss it up and hit it vertically, then you're going to have to care about diagonals, and that just makes the math a lot worse. Now, that's a head-on collision. You can also take a look at kicking the soccer ball. And if you do that, we can actually track both the soccer ball's motion and the motion of your foot. So let me show you in the computer right here. What we can do is under here, I've already clicked some motion on the soccer ball. We can also click on select active point and then switch to point series X2 and Y2. What this will let us do is add another set of points following the foot in addition to the soccer ball. That gives you two sets of points. You can analyze both of them, see some really cool motion on the interaction between the two. Now, if you want to get a little qualitative with this, we can also take a look at exactly what are the different types of collisions. We've got two rubber spheres here. One is the happy ball, one is the sad ball. One undergoes a fairly elastic collision, the other is fairly inelastic. Now, one ball, which doesn't really bounce, one which bounces quite well. And the happy ball is the one that has the largest change of momentum. Don't forget that momentum is a vector. The sad ball is the one with the smaller change of momentum. But once we know which ball is which, then we can try and understand exactly what's happening with the collision between these spheres and the block itself, and try and understand exactly what's going on there. Now, we've got a whole bunch more stations, including a bigger version of this. Let me clear the decks and show you those too. Now, if we want to take a look at the happy and sad balls in a big version, we've got an inflated basketball, but also a very deflated basketball. And what we're going to ask you to do is take a look at the collisions with the force plate. Again, you'll need to change the settings on the LabQuest unit to make sure that we're recording that 1,000 times per second, because that collision happens really quickly, and we want to know every little bit about what's going on with this collision. Now, we can also take a look in finer detail about what's happening when you add cushioning to a collision by comparing a basketball bouncing directly on the force plate with a basketball bouncing on a nice layer of cushion. Again, our question here is, what's the same about the collision? What's different about the collision? We have to do some calculations, but they should go pretty darn well. Now, we can also take a better look at exactly what's happening during the collision of the basketball itself by recording that collision with the ground with your high-speed camera. Now, before, we've done this measurement using the Sonic Rangers. Those will only record about 30 times a second. Having 300 frames per second gives us a much better idea of exactly how much force is at work during that collision. Now, we've done a whole bunch of linear momentum stuff. We can also take a look at angular momentum. Now, just like momentum in the linear sense is your mass, how much of you got, times by a velocity, how fast you're going. Angular momentum, we're going to care about the moment of inertia of an object, basically how much of it there is, times by, how fast is it spinning around, how fast it's going. What we're going to have you do is attach this wireless dynamic sensor system to the back of your chair, and when you spin around in the chair, this thing is actually going to make a measurement of your centripetal acceleration. Now, if you know the centripetal acceleration before and after you tuck your arms in really quick, then you can figure out what is your angular velocity before and after the arm tucking. So, as you can see, we've got a whole bunch of stations out this week. We'll probably have one or two more by the time you get to lab. So just make sure you take a moment, hit the books real hard, and we'll see you in lab.